I endeavor to help develop my students so that they also lead successful and empowered lives. Because if they're not thinking for themselves, then somebody else is doing the thinking for them, and their voice and their vision is removed. That is injustice. I want to thank everyone, especially TFCU and Region 19, for making us feel like rock stars. I also want to thank my SISD family for always supporting us, and also my principal and mentor, Ms. Patricia Cuevas. So the question of the day, who am I? Well, first and foremost, I'm a husband to a beautiful wife. I'm also a father of one. And if I scoot out of here, it's because my wife is calling me. We're currently expecting, and baby is due any moment. So just FYI. I'm also an El Paso native. I graduated from Isleta High School, rival to Riverside. Once an Indian, always an Indian. I also graduated from UTEP twice, once in undergrad with a bachelor's in history and a master's in history as well, thanks to SISD. I'm also blessed to be entering my 11th year as an educator. The past 6 years of that experience have been spent at America's High School. I am not only a teacher there, but also the coordinator of the Libertas Academy, which I and the team helped kick off back in 2012. The Libertas Academy, what is it? What is it about? It's a very unique program that caters to students who want to be attorneys, who want to be elected officials, who want to make a difference. These are students who just want to come in and be leaders. We're educating them today for tomorrow. We have an excellent staff. We have bar certified attorneys teaching these kiddos, teachers who are well versed in social and legal political thought. But the most important component to this program are the kiddos. And they're the ones who are going out there and working with local area attorneys to bring about change. They've created women's conferences. They've created, in fact, they're in the process of creating nonprofit organizations with local attorneys. They've worked with Rep. Mary Gonzalez. They've worked with all representatives around Texas, right? Very unique experiences for these students. But I guess the question of the day today, too, is who am I? Who am I as a person? So I guess the best way that I can summarize my teaching philosophy is through a story that you all might be familiar with. So a 24-year-old boy seen out from a train window shouted to his father, "Dad, look, the trees are going behind us." And the dad smiles. A couple sitting across from them kind of looks at the family perplexed, kind of with pity, because a child or the man is acting childish. Again, the boy, he shouts, says, "Dad, look at the clouds. They're coming with us." The dad smiles. And finally, the couple, unable to keep themselves, asks the dad, "Sir, have you taken your son to a good doctor?" And the dad, his response was, "Well, in fact, we're on our way back from a doctor. You see, my son was born blind. Today, he got his eyes." So that said, that's my teaching philosophy. Everyone has a story. Everyone is unique. I meet students where they are at to take the journey with them rather than tell them, you know what, you're behind, you're ahead, this is where you're supposed to be, right? Because oftentimes, for the very first time, they are also seeing what's outside of that window. I endeavor to help develop my students so that they also lead successful and empowered lives. Because if they're not thinking for themselves, then somebody else is doing the thinking for them, and their voice and their vision is removed. That is injustice. And finally, I educate and treat students as my own children. I take a journey with them, and I sit next to them, and all of us looking outside that window learn together. And that's what I'm about. Thank you.